me explain how Shiva is coming to this understanding, or Shiva is going to give us this understanding, how he comes to this conclusion step by step beautifully, and how he is going to transmit that understanding to us. People who have not attended last sutra should apologize me, should forgive me. I think you will find lot of things new, but nothing can be done because it is extension of last sutra. Next two sutras are also extensions. He is just taking us into a deeper and deeper layers, deeper and deeper levels. All right. When breath is all out and stopped itself, or all in and stopped, in such universal pause, one's small self vanishes. In the last sutra, he said, when the incoming breath taking turn as an outgoing breath, your mind disappears. Your mind doesn't exist. Now he says, the universe doesn't exist. Universal pause. In the last sutra he says mind, in this sutra he says universe. You need to understand an important thing. Your mind is universe. Universe is your mind. Even though Shiva doesn't give you any intellectual theories, concepts separately, he gives all the truth when he gives the techniques. It's an important thing you need to understand. The key or the essence of this sutra is mind and universe are one and the same. What you think as mind and what is this universe, what you perceive as universe, both are one and the same. Please understand. Sometime, because of your pain or suffering, you may say, how can this universe be directly connected to my mind, Swamiji? That is independent and my mind is separate. Whether you understand or not, truth is truth. A small story. One rabbi, after his retirement from the service, he went to hotel, want to fulfill his lifelong fantasy of eating pork. Somehow he couldn't control himself. He went to the hotel, chose a corner, he sat in a corner, ordered for pork. He was waiting. Waiting and fighting with his conscience. Not only was waiting and fighting with his conscience. As things will happen, one family from his congregation entered the hotel. According to Jews, nobody should eat alone. So naturally they straight came to the rabbi's table and sat in his table to share the food. In 5 minutes, waiter brought the big plate, opened the lid to reveal the roast suckling blood pig with a big full apple, baked the apple in the mouth. They were shocked, and rabbi also showed as if he was shocked, and he started shouting, see this place, you just order for a baked apple and what you get? You just order for a baked apple and what you get? You may use these words to escape from others, but you can't escape from yourself. And After it comes, you may think you are not ordered, or you may act you are not ordered, but nothing is served to you unless you order. Your mind and the universe, both are directly connected. What you enjoy, what you get from this universe is nothing but your mind. Shiva says in the last sutra, he says your mind stops. Now he says the universe stops. Your mind and the universe. In Vedanta we have a beautiful word, drishti srishti and srishti drishti. Drishti srishti and srishti drishti. Srishti drishti means what is you see. That's what we all believe. We are seeing what is. But drishti srishti means you create what you want to see. You create what you want to see. It's a little deeper level truth, difficult to understand with our ordinary logic, but truth. Whenever the mind stops, universe stops. Raman Maharshi explains this concept beautifully, this truth. Raman Maharshi explains beautifully. Whenever your mind is not functioning, the world is not functioning. The world will not function. You can see in your life. When you are in the dream space, that looks as reality. When you are in this space, this looks as reality. When you are here, this looks as reality. When you are in dream space, that space looks as a reality. When you are in deep sleep, nothing is reality, neither dream world nor this world. Let me be very clear, whenever you enter into the dream world, this whole jagrat or waking state, this world is completely faded. It becomes black and white and that becomes multicolor. As on now, you are dream world, when you remember your dreams, you feel it is like a black and white, vague. In India, if you see the Doordarshan, how it will come. And this world looks like a multicolor, strong, clear, like private channels. This looks like a, it's a 4D experience, four-dimension experience. If you go to the Universal Studio, that Shrek 2, they give you the 4D experience. Na? They rock the chair. 3D, you know, 4D is something like a, not only you have three-dimensional view, along with the movements, the chair also moves. And especially that mummy, they give you that mummy experience. Literally everybody shouts. They give you that 4D experience. Same way, now you are having this world in a 4D form. You are having the 4D experience of this world. And in the dream state, whenever you experience the dream consciousness, you experience dream state as 4D and this becomes 2D. This completely faded. This fades away and that becomes reality. Let you be very clear, then how can you decide or how can you choose which one is real or which one is unreal? You have no scale to choose whether this is real or that is unreal.